The Ministry of Tourism has been allocated 176.9 billion shillings for the financial year 2022-2023, leaving a funding gap of 87.2 billion shillings. The Minister of State for Tourism today sounded an alarm while appearing before the Parliamentary Committee on Trade and Tourism, saying underfunding is frustrating the sector, which earns Uganda a lot of foreign exchange.
Appropriation to the tourism sector have historically been below the threshold required for the industry to perform its role meaningfully. A sector that generates about 10% of the GDP cannot continually be allocated less than 0.4% of the national budget.
Before COVID-19, tourism was contributing 10% to GDP, fetching Uganda $1.6 billion per year in 2019, which reduced to $0.5 billion in 2020. Foreign visitors dropped by 69.3% and visitation to tourism sites dropped by 77% in 2020. However, the ministry is concerned that most of the initiatives undertaken to resuscitate the tourism sector, such as domestic tourism promotion, rollout of Pearl of Africa brand and others, have not been allocated funds.
With the ministry itself being the worst hit, we only have about 8% of what we need in terms of what we need to do in the NDP3. Uganda Wildlife Authority is at 65%, UWEC is at 43%, UHTTI at 26%, UWRTI at 62%.
State Minister for Tourism Martin Mugara also decried the 40% budget cuts, which affected all ministries, departments and agencies in the current financial year, saying the undertaking has left them trapped between a rock and a hard place. Budget cuts were directed at activities deemed consumptive, such as advertising, public relations, travels abroad, inland travel, consultancy services, maintenance, hiring venues, allowances and subvention, among others, which affected the tourism promotion.
With COVID-19, it is important that we get an appropriate response in order to recover Uganda's tourism, starting with funding the MDAs, because tourism has high transformative power to the economy if fully harnessed.
Mugara disclosed that he presented this matter to Cabinet on the 1st of March 2021 and a decision was taken to exempt the entity and Uganda Tourism Board. The Ministry of Tourism is now courting members of Parliament to compel the Ministry of Finance to reverse all funding which was cut. The Ministry of Tourism is now courting members of Parliament to compel the Ministry of Finance to reverse all funding which was cut to help in resuscitating the tourism sector.
I did raise this matter of underfunding and the effect of budget cuts on consumptive items on tourism to the attention of Cabinet, and Cabinet agreed that at least the budget of tourism of the tourism votes, meager as it is, should be exempted from budget cuts and the reversal be made for the cuts that had been made.
Committee members have vowed to press the Ministry of Finance to allocate money to all unfunded activities of the tourism ministry before the budget is approved.
We need enough statistics and even show the forecasts, show the president how much do we expect if we invest this much. It is a must. And we use that forecast to be assertive and get the money.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.